guys, Barry from Rockville here, and today I'm going to teach you how to set up your RPA70 WBT hybrid amplifier and receiver. This system is perfect for home theaters, karaoke, listening to music, and much more. Now in this video, I'm teaching you guys how to set up your RPA70 WBT, but this also applies for your RPA60 BT. The only difference is that this amp comes with two wireless mics. So the RPA70 WBT comes with the receiver and amplifier, two wireless microphones, a power cable, a wireless remote control, and two sets of antennas for the AM and FM radio. It also comes with two sets of rack ears that you can use to mount onto your rack. Now it's very easy to set up these rack ears onto your RPA70 WBT. All we'll want to do is take one of the rack ears and line up the three holes on the ears to the three holes you see on the side of the amp. Then we'll take three of the six included screws and use them to tighten the ears onto the amp. After that, you're ready to mount the amp onto your rack. Next thing you'll want to do is take the included power cable and plug it into the back of the receiver into the power socket. Now remember, this is a powered amplifier and receiver, so that means I'm going to need some speakers to hear anything at all. So let me go grab some real quick. Okay, so for this demo, I'm using our RockShelf passive speakers, but just remember, you can use any pair of passive speakers as long as the impedance does not fall below 4 ohms. Now, there are four sets of terminal outputs on the back here, two for A and two for B. Now, each channel is 4 ohms stable. This means if I wanted to, I could actually run four 16 ohm passive speakers off the amp. I'll show you how to do that in a bit, but first, let's start by wiring our speakers to the terminals. So first we want to start by unscrewing these terminals on the back here. Run the red wire into the red terminal like this. Then take the black wire and run it to the black terminal like this. Then you'll take the other end of the speaker cable and run them into the red and black terminals on the back of the speaker like this. Now the setup for the other speaker you want to use will be the exact same. All right, so now that I've got my two speakers connected, we can go ahead and turn the unit on. Now you'll notice when you turn the unit on that the blue LED display along with the buttons on the side light up. Now these buttons in the front will actually control all the features on the RPA. We can use this input button to control our sources like our MP3, aux, CD or DVD player, and AM and FM radio. We can use this menu button to control our treble and bass EQs, along with the balance between the left and the right speaker. We can use this mute button to mute the whole system, and this LED light actually turns the LED on and off. So if we look on the other side, we have the previous and next buttons that we can use to switch between songs or your radio signals, the AM and FM button to switch between radios, and the auto scan button will actually find your nearest radio stations. Now, if we don't want to use the buttons on the front of the amp, we also have the included wireless remote control that can control things like the input, as well as the EQ, the volume, and much more. Now, if you wanted to listen to the radio through the RPA70, you'll need these two antennas to connect to the back of the amplifier here. Now, the great thing about the RPA70 is that there are many different ways to input into the amp. You have the aux input on the front of the amp that you can use for your iPod or MP3 player, and you also have the RCA inputs on the back of the amp. You can use this input for your DVD or CD player, but you can also use it for the main input for your home theater setup. All you'll want to do is grab an RCA cable, plug one end into the audio output of your TV, then take the other end of that cable and plug that into the RCA input on the back of the amp. And the last input we could use is the Bluetooth. Let me show you how to set that up now. What we're gonna wanna do is press the input button till we get to the Bluetooth mode. Once you hear that chime, you'll know you're in Bluetooth mode. Next, you'll want to go to the Bluetooth settings of your smartphone or tablet and find the device listed Rockville Amp. Once you pair with the device, you'll hear a chime, which means you are connected to the device. So now let's hear some music. So now that we've got some music playing, we can actually control the volume of the music through our master volume knob. So if we want it any louder, we'll turn it clockwise. Mentioned before, we can run four 16 ohm speakers through the RPA70, but on top of that, we could also run a subwoofer through the sub output on the back. Let me set those up now. Now, setup for the additional speakers are gonna be the exact same as the first speakers we set up. Since at first we've connected to channels right A and left B, we're gonna take two more red and black wires and connect them to the left A and right B terminals, and then connect them to the new speakers. Alright, so now that I have four speakers connected, let me show you how to run your subwoofer. Now on the back of the amp, you'll notice the RCA output labeled sub out. Then you'll just take an RCA cable, plug two ends to the sub out, then take the other ends and plug those into the RCA inputs of your subwoofer. Let's hear what it sounds like. So now I'm playing the music from all four speakers, and we can control how much volume comes out of the subwoofer with this sub out knob. So if I boost that up, you start to hear the bass really bumping. So now we have all five speakers connected, which makes it perfect for a home theater setup. Now another really cool feature on the RPA70 is that it comes with two wireless mics. Let me show you those now. Now in order to use the microphone, you're gonna need two AA batteries. We can put those in by unscrewing the bottom of the microphone. Take one battery and put it in like this, then take the other battery and put it in like this. Then take the bottom part and screw it back onto the mic. Next, what we'll want to do is turn up the mic volume knob so that we're able to hear the microphone through the system. After that, we just turn the mic on, and you should be able to hear me come through the speakers. Now, there are two antennas on the back of the amp that we can use to optimize the signal of our wireless microphones. Now, we can even use this mic tone knob to increase the presence of our voice. So as you can hear, I'm coming through the system a lot more clearly. And another really cool feature is this echo knob over here that we can use to give our voice an echo effect. So if I turn it up, you'll hear the echo come through the speakers. Now these knobs won't just affect the two included wireless microphones, but they'll also affect the microphones you plug into the mic 1 and mic 2 quarter inch inputs. So we can use up to four microphones, two wireless and two wired, through the amplifier. Now a popular setup that people use all the time is that they will take their smartphone or tablet, connect to the Bluetooth, look up a karaoke version of a song on the YouTube app, and use the wireless or wired microphones for an awesome karaoke setup. Now, if we wanted to expand our setup even further, we have the RCA pre-outputs here that we can connect to a powered speaker or even another amplifier. So I hope this showed you guys how easy it is to set up your RPA70 WBT hybrid amplifier and receiver, as well as your RPA60BT. But of course, if you have any questions or concerns, feel free to reach our customer support team through phone or email. As always, I'm Perry from Rockville,
and I'll see you guys next time.